hockey world loves a game seven. May the best team win.
Feel the tension. This is why you play.
Stanley Cup's in the building. Someone's winning it.
One more for the Stanley Cup.
Score! The Blues have scored first in game seven. Will be made tonight in Boston. The wait is over, and the St. Louis Blues are the Stanley Cup champions. This is not a dream. This is real life St. Louis. Let's party.
Well, that was the moment they won the Stanley Cup, and this summer they've been taking it literally everywhere. A trio of Blues, Bozak, Shen, and Schwartz, trying to fire up the CFL crowd there, the Saskatchewan Rough Riders game. Oh, how about that jersey reveal, huh? Look at these guys.
Oh, boy.
A couple of Saskatchewan natives right there.
That's a fun summer.
Yeah. Right? Short but sweet in a good kind of way. Speaking of sweet, Zach Sanford agreeing to terms on a two-year, $3 million contract with the Blues on Monday. The contract has an AAV of $1.5 million and allows the 24-year-old forward to avoid arbitration. Zach Sanford, of course, coming in clutch, entering the lineup in the middle of the Stanley Cup final, and he played a big role for the St. Louis Blues. So we take a look at some of the other guys that need to file to avoid arbitration. Jordan Binnington may be the most important on this list. You know what this kid did.
Yeah, he is. Is the most important on that list. I can be very clear on that. He
Oscar
is.
Sundquist, Joel Edmondson, the others. Jordan Binnington, do you think he's going to go to arbitration, or do you think both sides will kind of iron out a deal before they get to that meeting?
That's a great question, because it is an interesting negotiation, because Jordan Binnington doesn't have a big track record outside of half a season in the National Hockey League and what he did in the postseason, which is pretty substantial. What he did in the postseason, really, in my mind, should have been the Conn Smythe Trophy winner, not taking anything away from Ryan O'Reilly, but I just thought Binnington was the guy that should have won that award. He was the difference maker for this team, gave him every opportunity to get better in the regular season, get to the playoffs in the first place. And then he always found a way to make the big save, and particularly in Game 7, first period against the Boston Bruins, he was just lights out. So it's an interesting negotiation. The former Blues goaltender Mike Liut is the agent for Jordan Binnington. He's a goaltender. He knows this market very well. Doug Armstrong has been around for a long time, the manager of the St. Louis Blues. So I'm sure they'll try to work something out prior to arbitration. But going to arbitration might not be the worst thing for the St. Louis Blues in terms of a short-term deal that gets them through the now, and they can continue to discuss what they think about long-term and see a little bit more from Jordan Binnington. The only negative is that if he continues to play very well, all of a sudden the value goes up and he gets those unrestricted years, it could be very difficult then to re-sign him, but or become more challenging. Mm-hmm. But you have two veteran groups here. Again, that Liut camp, Mike Liut's been doing this for a long time on the agent side, and Doug Armstrong's been negotiating contracts in the National Hockey League, you know, going back for more than 20 years now. So at some point, I think they will get something done, but it'll be interesting how it happens, whether it goes through the arbitration process or whether they can come to a longer-term agreement without that.
And like you said earlier, one of the benefits of arbitration is that a contract gets done, and then you can focus on maybe the longer-term plan going forward.
Yes.
What do you think the plan is with Pat Maroon? It was such a great story, taking less money, betting on himself, coming back home. Maybe the regular season didn't play out how he wanted, but he was the hometown hero, scoring that double overtime game winner, Game 7 against Dallas, to send him to the Western Conference Finals, and obviously winning a Stanley Cup and having his son on the ice, and it seems like both sides can't really come to an agreement right
now. I think it's more the St. Louis Blues have just decided that, you know, that was a one-and-done type situation. Patrick Maroon is a big, burly player in a league that has really gone to more speed. Now, he was a great fit on that line with Robert Thomas and Tyler Bozak, but you can see the numbers here. Not big time numbers, although important guy in the room. I think there is a contract out there for Pat Maroon with perhaps another team. I think if I was talking as his agent to the Blues, I would try to sell the Blues on a lower salary on a longer term, maybe, you know, a 1.2 over 2 or 3 years, because of the local factor and because he is a player in certain parts of the season and in particular games that can be really helpful for you, despite the fact that he isn't the big speedy forward. he's someone that does bring that size and strength around the net. So I get the sense, based on what I've heard, that that he is probably going to have to go elsewhere. We'll see if it plays out that way. But it was a season to remember for Patrick Maroon, to go back to your hometown and to win the Stanley Cup, the first in franchise history. I hope something can get worked out, but it just seems like it's going in another direction.
Yeah, well, if we've learned anything from the last two Stanley Cup champions, Washington Capitals, St. Louis Blues, it's regular season speed and skill, but come playoff time, there's still that, need.
Toughness,
exactly. Size and strength and wearing teams down over the course of a seven-game series.